Okay. Previously, we've mentioned that the thresholding stopping rule should be used if we want to reach a desired confidence level. Here, I will show the relation between accumulated evidence and the confidence level. This confidence level can be represented by a maximum error rate alpha, which is the probability to choose right when the true distribution is left, or the other way around. Here, we make it symmetric for simplicity. So in this way, the evidence threshold A is related to error rate threshold alpha by these two formulas. In our case, a left is smaller than zero and a right is greater than zero, and they are opposite of each other. Now it's your turn. In exercise three, you will simulate drift diffusion models with thresholding stopping rule. You need to implement the threshold stopping rule given a desired error rate. After that, please run some simulations and use our provided code to visualize the accumulated evidence as a function of time. Here is a sample plot for reference. Let's now look at the speed accuracy trade-off under thresholding stopping rule. To do this, run multiple simulations for each error rate alpha and calculate the average decision accuracy and average decision speed for each given alpha. The decision speed is just the reciprocal of decision time for one simulation. After that, use our provided code to visualize the relation between accuracy and speed. And don't forget to use the sliders to explore how the curve changes with signal-to-noise ratio. Have fun.